Is anyone still reading the newspaper? Why are they making these things half the size of your body? They can make a computer that fits in the palm of your hand, but the newspaper needs to be equal to the wingspan of the adult man. I saw a headline recently that said, "Oldest man dies." No, he didn't. It's just a new oldest man. He used to be the oldest man. Now, he's just the youngest dead guy. And why is this news? I mean, who was surprised by this? Of course the oldest man died. He was the oldest man. That's what old men do.
Working out, Elaine. She was treating my apartment like a sports club. Yoga in the morning, bicycle in my kitchen. I had 300 pounds of free weights in my bedroom.
It does smell musty in here.
Elaine, exercise in the apartment should live in two separate worlds. Besides, it's just nice to have the place back to myself again. You spoke too soon.
My legs are killing me, Jim. I was at the DMV for 4 hours. 4 hours! It's a line in the middle of the building. No chairs.
Sounds like torture.
It's barbaric. What they need is a surface on the wall to take the weight off. People want to lean, Jerry. You got nowhere to lean in here. You got a chair for sitting, a couch for lounging, but nothing for leaning. I can't be in here right now. Come on.
Well, that's a shame. Yeah?
It's George.
Well, I have got to run. I have a salon appointment. Jerry, it's just up the street. Have you been?
To the salon? No.
Jerry, you've gotta go. I have struck gold.
Good cuts?
Great cuts! And what's better is I can talk with this woman about anything. It's like having a best friend who cuts my hair.
And that's the thing about the hairdresser. You need a good cut, and you need a good conversation.
The cut and the conversation.
The conversation and the cut.
Well, I hope everybody's sitting down!
You remember Susan, my ex-fiancée?
Of course, how could I forget her? She's the reason I only use self-adhesive envelopes.
She's back.
She's back?
Susan is back.
Susan is back, but she died.
You think I don't know that?
Well, is there anything different about her?
Skin is very damp.
Well, what happened?
I have no idea. But yesterday she just knocked on my door as if nothing had ever changed.
Jerry!
Susan!
It's been so long.
It has been. It has been very long.
George, you don't forget we have dinner with the Farkases on Friday.
Yep, Friday. It's Monday, we still got plenty of time.
Watch the attitude, please, mister.
Jerry, talk soon.
That is the death of single George, Jerry.
Are you sure that you two are still together? I thought it was till death do you part.
She's not dead.
But she died.
Not anymore.
But you're part.
Whoa, we were very part.
And now you're back.
Right back in the thick of it. Of course, I'm happy that she's alive.
Of course, you're not a monster.
Not at all. But that relationship never should have been resurrected.
Well, at least now you're having, you know.
She's one of the
the ground for 10 years. I don't know what's going on down there.
And when has that ever stopped you before?
Funny guy! Funny guy, you're very funny, Jerry. You know that? You're very funny.
Wait a second. We spent a lot of money on that gravesite. I'm gonna get my money back.
George, I don't think that's the policy.
How could they have a policy? This has never happened before. I'm gonna march up and demand that they give me a refund.
Well, at least you're getting something out of all this, George.
Behold. The movability of the stand, the comfort of the reading.
Did you just make
that? You know it. My only problem is I can't think of a name for it.
Yeah, that's your only problem.
And then he tells me that he didn't get 12 years a slave.
What?
Yes, what is there to get?
Exactly.
And what's worse? He went to the lobby and got Twizzlers and refused to share any of them with me.
Okay, that is worse.
That ended that. Anyway, thank you so much for taking me today, Anastasia.
Oh, yeah.
I am getting my license photo taken.
Oh, pressure's on then. Because you're going to be looking at this haircut for the next 10 years, huh?
Exactly! This is so fun!
Yeah. Okay, sorry, one second. Hello.
Oh my god. When did it happen? Oh my god.
Thank you. smells like the outdoors. Like sweat and motor oil. He smells like shit. Toots cologne. How a man should smell.
Susan won't do.
I could have sworn Susan was dead.
It didn't take.
Oh.
Anyway, she's at the DMV right now. Her license expired.
Oh, good luck with that place. No thank you.
George, hang on a second. This is perfect.
Yeah?
Yeah. I'll go down to the DMV and meet Susan, and then I'll get her to tell me how she did the whole dead thing. And then I can reanimate Anastasia's cousin. And get my cut and my conversation.
You really think she'd tell you?
Sure, girl talk.
Because she did not want to tell me, and I'm her fiancé.
George, women have a sacred code of girl talk that men will just never understand.
You know, this may be the first time I'm admitting this. I don't think I understand women.
Oh.
Excuse you.
Pardon my lean.
What is that?
This? This is a leaning Susan. Perfect for those on their feet all day long. Only $39.89.
Take it. Oh, I only have a 20.
That'll do just fine.
we have a bereavement rate on license photos.
Elaine?
Susan!
Hi!
People in casual conversation. Hey, how's it going? These people are part of a brand new market, the leaning market, perfect for Sky Mall.
Oh, I saw, what are you all called?
I call it the leaning Susan. They're gonna be everywhere. You know James Dean?
Oh, James Dean, James Dean.
Dean used to lean.
Mr. Kramer, you are a smart man. Very, very smart man.
I think we are leaning on a winner.
Absolutely not.
Georgie, let's fool around.
Now, right in the middle of Bad About You.
So, we have the whole series on DVD.
Oh, so damn. Okay.
Come on, Georgie, neither one of us has had sex in over 10 years. Come on, I'll massage your hot knees.
No thanks, they are very cold.
Jerry, there are laws against that. In most states, there are laws
against that!
Well, you can't stay here. Stay at Kramer's.
No, no, no. No one can sleep in my showroom, not even me.
Well, then where are you sleeping?
I've been staying with Newman. But I can't stay there tonight.
Why not?
There's a mailbag on the door, Jerry. Means he's got a girl in there.
So it's a sleepover.
Well, you can't stay here. There's Leaning Susan's all over the couch.
What about your bed?
Yeah.
You two are not sleeping on my bed.
Why not? You got a girl in there?
No.
All right, it's a sleepover.
He doesn't understand women.
Nope. You don't get women. Newman.
Restaurants. If you don't have food in your house, go to a restaurant. There's food there. Paid for by the National Car Farmers Association.
Pizza, pizza.
Commercials. Wow.
Potatoes.
Paid for by Saddam Hussein.
What is this great? Isn't this great? Marissa Tomei on Netflix? What could be better?
Well, for starters, you could be wearing pants.
I have very hot knees. I can't sleep with bottoms on.
All right, well, fine. How do you want to do this anyway, sleep position-wise?
Why don't we spoon? I can be the big spoon.
I don't see how that's possible. I'm clearly the bigger spoon.
You don't have to be bigger to be the big spoon.
I think you do. That's why they call it the big spoon.
You're just like Susan, you know that? You always gotta be the bigger spoon.
All right, fine, we'll sleep head to toe, head to toe.
Hey, Marissa Tomei, start it over. I wanna watch from the beginning.
No, Kramer, we're going to bed. How are you even sleeping on that thing anyway?
Like a baby, Jerry. Like a baby.
Oh, come on.
Well, that's my cue.
Careful, you can be careful. Well, this is just fantastic. Oh, hot knees!
You know, George, for a woman who's been dead 10 years, you would think Susan wouldn't be so sensitive. You guys look terrible. What happened?
We had a sleepover.
Grown men? A little sleepover?
Let's just say the sleeping situation was less than ideal. A drunken knee pushing? And a whole lot of bed hogging.
I don't know what you guys are talking about. I slept fine. Yeah.
It's Susan.
Hey, come on up.
No, Kramer, come on. Why would you do that?
I like Susan.
No.
Georgie? Georgie! What happened? You went out to get your steps and you never came home. You must have burned a muffin.
So damn.
Georgie, I was out all night looking for you. I mean, I'm a mess. Susan. We're supposed to have dinner with the Farkases on Friday. What am I going to do?
Susan, I have the perfect idea. Listen, I have a salon appointment. It is just up the street. Why don't you take my appointment?
You don't mind?
Kramer is storing them here.
Well, that's silly. You should put them in Georgie's storage space he's always bragging about.
Hey, that's a great idea.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, everybody, grab a leaning Susan. We're going to the storage space.
Yeah.
Perfect. We can just swing by the salon on the way.
You see that, Jerry? Now she takes my storage space.
The last vestige of single George. Well, that's a shame. Well, la-ti-da, if it isn't the famous salon.
Hey, I know this place. Made a delivery here last week.
Okay, this will just take a minute. Anastasia! Oh, my God. Hi!
Hi, listen. This is my friend Susan.
Hi.
Susan's been in a rough place for a while now, so I wanted to give my appointment to her.
Oh, that's so nice of you, Elaine. My cousin would have really liked that.
Okay.
No. In the chair.
Here we go.
Nope.
Well, she seems really nice.
Oh, she is a real peppy gal.
Oh, good.
Oh, you have one too.
Yeah.
Trust the lead.
That's right.
By the way, Kramer, this thing is a real lifesaver.
See? They trust the lead.
This is my life now. Dinner with the Farkases and hanging out at salons. Susan is alive and single George is dead.
So anyway, that's how I came back to life.
What?
Ow!
Well, anyway, your hair is really damp.
Right.
So I'm going to have to use my special scissors.
Okay.
Joe, I think that's enough.